You will hear a talk on the topic of the caveman diet. First, you have some time to look at questions 31 to 40. Now listen carefully and answer questions 31 to 40.
Hello everyone. Do you use the internet? If I asked you what is the single most common topic for advertisements on the net, I suspect ads for weight loss would win hands down. After all, dieting is one of our current obsessions. We've all heard of the Atkins diet, the macrobiotic plan, the South Beach diet, the raw food eating plan. All of these fad diets and many more promise that you will lose kilos and live a healthy life if you just follow their plan. Today we're going to discuss one of the most well-known Western diet trends, the paleo or caveman diet. Firstly, what is this diet? And where did it come from? Proponents of this diet argue that we need to return to basics, that is, to what our forebears ate many years ago. They say that our bodies are not well suited to digest complex carbohydrates such as grains and legumes. We should be eating a hunter-gatherer diet, rich in lean meat, fish, nuts and berries, and without wheat, oats or other grains that came into our diet after the invention of agriculture. Sounds logical, doesn't it? But let's look a little closer. The first question to ask about the caveman diet is, what did our ancestors actually eat? One way to discover this is to study the diets of existing hunter-gatherer tribes. Although these groups do tend to regard meat as the best source of food, they often have difficulty in finding it. In Africa, for example, over 50% of the time, the bushmen tribes come home empty-handed from their hunting expeditions, despite being very skillful with equipment such as bows and arrows. So what do they eat when they can't get meat? Well, the wives come to the fore then, foraging for and cooking local plants. Most of the groups eat a lot of plants. These range through a huge variety of local species, including nuts, plantains and yams, and evidence suggests that this was true of our ancient ancestors as well. Researchers suggest that these people would eat more meat if they could get it, but in fact only approximately a third of their calories comes from this protein and fat-rich source. Research shows that when these groups first come into contact with a Western diet, their health suffers. Once they're exposed to our diet of refined carbohydrates and sugars, they quickly develop our lifestyle-related diseases. However, that does not mean that the human digestive system is suited to digesting only a few sources of food, nor that it cannot change to accommodate different food sources. In fact, the evidence would suggest exactly the opposite. As a species, we are able to make significant modifications to our digestive systems according to what foods are available in our local environment. Examples abound, and our ability to digest lactose is a good one. Lactose is a sugar that is found in milk, and it is digested in the human gut by the enzyme lactase. In communities in Europe, the Middle East and Africa that traditionally herd cattle and drink cow's milk, this enzyme is present and people can digest milk products. However, in places such as China and Thailand, which do not have this style of farming, the enzyme is lacking, and most people have lactose intolerance. Another example is the ability to digest the sugars from starchy foods. Communities that eat a lot of these foods have saliva that breaks down starchy foods before they reach the gut, whereas other groups have more difficulty in getting nutrition from high starch sources. In fact, if you look at indigenous cultures around the world, there is a huge variety of successful diets. The Inuit get nearly all of their energy from high fat sources, such as seal meat. The Jains in India have religious beliefs which prohibit eating any living thing, including eggs, but which do, however, allow for the consumption of milk products. Other groups eat mostly fish or have an insect-based diet, depending on locally available sources of protein. So the idea that our caveman ancestors ate one homogeneous diet and that if we follow this we can all be healthy would seem to be an oversimplification. Diets are the result of complex cultural dietary practices. People can and will eat just about anything. So, if we can eat a variety of diets, is there anything actually wrong with following the caveman diet? Well, firstly, on a practical level, it's an expensive way to get your daily calories. Few of us can afford to satisfy all of our energy requirements on a diet which depends on lean wild meat and nut oils. A few carbohydrates provide a cheap, filling, and substantial energy boost for most of us. Secondly, a diet which includes a large proportion of red meat may not be good for our long-term health if our bodies are adapted to a sedentary lifestyle and a plant-based diet. We simply get less exercise than our ancestors did, and so we are more prone to some illnesses than they were. Finally, if we all start to eat a wild meat-based diet, this will have negative implications for the environment, because it's not a sustainable way to feed a lot of people.
That is the end of section 4. You now have half a minute to check your answers. That is the end of the listening test.